We're going to clear up some misconceptions about coffee grounds in this short, or at least hopefully short, episode of Coffee and Compost. My name is Steve Churchill, and I own the Urban Worm Company. Now, if you're a functioning adult on this earth, chances are that you are drinking coffee to get you going in the morning. If you're like me, that cup is probably more like a pot of coffee. And if you're really like me, then you would probably sell one of your children before ever giving up coffee in your day. So you are probably producing a lot of good worm food. But there are some misconceptions around it. First of all, is it a brown or a green? Is it acidic or not acidic? And why is it that worms don't necessarily like coffee grounds the second you put them into your worm bin? We're going to cover that right now. There are some misunderstandings about coffee grounds and whether they are a brown or a green. Now, coffee grounds may be brown, but they are not a brown. In other words, they're not a carbon-rich brown material like dead leaves or paper or cardboard. They actually have a carbon to nitrogen ratio of 20 to 1, meaning they are relatively high in nitrogen. So you're going to have to balance them out with that carbon-rich material, like the paper, cardboard, peat moss, all the other kind of deader brown stuff that you're going to put in your worm bin. But coffee grounds themselves are high in nitrogen, so make sure to keep adding that bedding. Now, a lot of people worry about the acidity of coffee, but this too is a misunderstanding. Now, I love coffee that's strong enough to tear the varnish off of wooden furniture, but it's the coffee itself that's acidic. The acid in that coffee is water soluble, so it is going to come out during the brewing process. And those coffee grounds that it leaves behind, regardless of what the starting acidity of the coffee itself was, those coffee grounds are going to be pH neutral, probably 6.5 to 6.8 pH, maybe slightly acidic, but for the most part pH neutral. There should be no worries when it comes to what coffee grounds are doing to the pH in your worm bin. Now, if you're already using coffee grounds in your worm bin, you may notice that the worms don't really take to the grounds too quickly. And this makes sense. So you got to keep in mind that worms really only go after food waste after it has started to become decomposed by bacteria. And so what did you just do to those coffee grounds? You sterilized them with scalding hot water. Most coffee brewing takes place at a temperature of around 195 to 205 degrees Fahrenheit, which effectively sterilizes those grounds. So I like to let my coffee grounds sit out for a bit, kind of let them fester, let them get some of that bacterial decomposition going, and then I add it to my worm bin. I find that the worms take to it pretty readily then. So remember, coffee grounds are a green material. They are pH neutral, and they're likely sterile if fresh. Okay, guys, I've been doing this for a few years now, since 2014. That's when I started the Urban Worm Company, and I have noticed that most new vermicomposters are making the same mistakes over and over, and most vermicomposters are making more than one. So I created this handy little guide to help you steer clear of some of these vermicomposting landmines. Up above my left shoulder, I think it's right up here, there's going to be a little button for you to click, and you can go get this guide immediately. It's a quick read, it's a fun read, and I think it's going to help you out a lot. Thanks again, everybody. We'll see you on the next episode of Coffee and Compost.